Hi, I'm in Zhongshan, and right behind me is one of the most ambitious infrastructure projects ever undertaken in China. It's the Shenzhen Zhongshan Bridge, and it's not just a bridge, it's also a tunnel with an artificial island in the middle of the water where you transit from the tunnel to the bridge, and it's absolutely amazing. Today we're going to take you on it. I've got cameras all around the car and I've got my drone, so without further ado, let's go.
Officially opened in June 2024, the Shenzhen Zhongshan Bridge is one of the largest infrastructure projects in China. Located in Guangdong Province, this 24-kilometer mega project connects the cities of Shenzhen and Zhongshan, dramatically reducing travel time between the two from about 2 hours to less than 30 minutes. The bridge is part of the larger Pearl River Delta development strategy designed to enhance connectivity within the Greater Bay Area, which includes major cities like Hong Kong, Macau, Guangzhou and Shenzhen. The Shenzhen Zhongshan Bridge is not just a single structure, but a complex cross-sea link that includes two main bridges, an underwater tunnel and two artificial islands. The project includes a 5,035 meter long immersed tube tunnel, which is the longest and one of the most challenging of its kind in the world. It is made up of 32 prefabricated sections, each weighing 80,000 tons. These sections were built off site and then precisely installed under the sea, transported and installed using the world's largest and most advanced ship specifically built for this purpose. This method reduced the environmental impact and improved the efficiency and safety of the construction process. The construction of the Shenzhen Zhongshan Bridge project officially began in December 2016. The project took approximately 7.5 years to complete, with the bridge opening to traffic on June the 30th, 2024. The total cost of the bridge project is estimated to be approximately $7 billion. This substantial investment reflects the scale and complexity of the project, which is one of the largest in China. The bridge is particularly noteworthy for setting 10 world records related to its construction. The largest span of all offshore steel box girder suspension bridges, having a main span of 1,666 meters. The world's highest deck with a height of 91 meters. Anchorage of the offshore bridge, using 344,000 cubic meters of concrete per anchor. The world's highest wind speed, with a maximum wind speed of 83.7 meters per second tested. The world's largest asphalt bridge surface, having a surface area of 378,000 square meters. The longest two-way, eight-lane subsea tunnel, with a total length of 5,035 meters. The widest steel hull and concrete subsea tunnel, with a total width of 46 meters, a height of 10.6 meters, and each of the 32 sections 165 meters long. The largest concrete pouring, with each pipe pouring 29,000 cubic meters and a total of 910,000 cubic meters. The world's first underwater highway airport hub interchange. The world's largest retractable M-shaped water stop, with a width of 3 meters, was used for the final fitting of the immersed tube. Thank you. So after driving on the bridge, going through the tunnel over the bridge, I was even more impressed. It is a really amazing feat of engineering. I'm from an engineering background. I love that kind of engineering and the difficulty of building that they've overcome. They've achieved new engineering practices just to build that, and I'm sure other countries around the world may follow some of those practices. We drove right across it. It cost 64 RMB per car. It was very busy when we were on there. It'd be really interesting to calculate, like, if you knew the amount of traffic per day, and at 64 RMB per day, obviously there's operating costs, but it'd be interesting to know how long it will take them to recover that sort of almost $7 billion of the build cost. We previously had drove to Zhongshan. It took us about 2.5-3 hours. This time it took us like 35 minutes. So it makes a major difference, you know, connecting the east and the west of the Greater Bay Area. And it's just a small another piece in the jigsaw puzzle of turning the Greater Bay Area, Macau, Hong Kong, Zhuhai, Shenzhen, Guangzhou into sort of a mega city. You know, there's over, I think there's about 100 million people in the Greater Bay Area. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it's about that. I think in Guangdong as a whole, it's like 120 million. But it's, you know, it's the engine of China from technology. And it is really, really impressive that they've done this. Anyway, I hope you liked the video. We got some great drone footage. We drove in the car. We got the footage off the cameras. Really hope you enjoyed it. But as always, for now, take care.